and hear your voice tonight. Jesus, hold me now.
Thank you. the morning when I die.
Those of y'all that's never met, go ahead and turn your Bibles for me this morning to the book of Matthew. We'll give you the chapter 6. We're going to read a little bit from the Word of God. Those of you that's never met Miss Caroline, I met Miss Caroline when she was 18 years old. We sang together on the road for about 18 years, 11 years of that was full-time ministry. And it's so great to have her back. She's my sister in Christ, Miss Caroline. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. The book of Matthew, children, you are dismissed for children's shirts. Miss Courtney will be standing back there with her hand up. We love you, Miss Courtney. Praise the Lord for children's church ministry.
Amen.
Chapter 6, we're going to start in verse 9. This is Jesus talking. Anytime your Bible is in red, it's the Lord Jesus talking. The Bible says in verse 9, "After this manner, therefore, pray ye, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen." I remember memorizing this prayer in school, believe it or not. Our school used to open every day, and our principal would lead us with this prayer over the intercom system. I also remember pledging allegiance to the flag because we were proud Americans as children. And then some time along the way, the morals and the values left this country, and no one wanted to pray anymore, and it was offensive to pray in school. But you children, listen to me. Even in the children's church, they're going to hear this. Take your Bibles to school. Pray when you want to. You are a child of God. The Amen. Lord will take care of you. Amen. Do you agree with me this morning?
Amen.
Lift the name of Jesus up. The government is going to try to stop this. The leaders are going to try to stop this. But it's up to the Christian people to keep praying these prayers in the name of Jesus. Jesus said, don't pray on the side of the streets like the hypocrites do with many words. You see, it don't matter how you sound when you pray. It's all about conversation, a personal relationship with Jesus. Talking to Him like you talk to me. Talking to Him you're talking to your Father. Pour your heart out to Him. He said, don't have vain, repetitious prayers when you talk to Jesus, but come with me, come to me with thanksgiving, praying like this: Our Father who art in heaven. You remember learning that prayer as a child?
Amen.
Hallowed, which is holy, be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That means that we can have a little touch of heaven here on earth.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you're singing a gospel song or you hear a good message or you're in church and the Holy Spirit starts moving between the pews, all we have to do is reach out and touch His garment. We can feel the very presence of an Almighty God. Mm-hmm. That's a taste of heaven on this side of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
God said He'll never leave us nor forsake us. I go to prepare a place for you, but I put here a comforter. That is the Holy Spirit that you feel in your heart. Amen. When He passes by, when He passes by, He brings miracles. He brings healing. Amen. And all we have to do is be obedient to His word and worship. Remember, we preached about worshiping in spirit and in truth. When the Holy Spirit passes by you, worship in spirit and truth, and He will answer your prayers.
Amen.
Holy be thy name. The Bible also goes on to say, forgive those who trespass, it says debtors, trespass against you as He forgave you. Amen. That means we can't go to heaven with an unforgiving heart.
Amen.
We can't get into glory if we hate somebody. We can't get into glory if we can't forgive somebody
Amen.
For what they've done to us. Jesus forgave us on the cross. He said, forgive them, for they know not what they do. No matter what people say about you and what people do to you, in sincerity, in a prayer, say, Lord, I forgive them because you forgave me.
Amen.
You forgave me of every sin. I don't know about you, but my life was pretty dark. Man, I was, you looked in the dictionary under sin and it said Bobby Wright right beside it. I was a sinner. I didn't care about nobody. I didn't care about your welfare. I didn't care about myself. I didn't care about anything in this world. All I cared about was getting mine. But God looked through all of that sin, all of that blackness one day. God looked through all of that. And He said, you know, the world may not forgive you, Bobby Wright, but I forgive you and I love you. And you know what? I died on a cross so that you could go to heaven. Boy, when I heard those words, when I read those words out of the book, I said, Lord, you mean you knew my name? This old low-down black sinner like me with a black heart, you knew my name. You mean you forgive me, Lord? I did some pretty bad things. He said, I forgive you.
Amen.
I forgive you, Bobby Wright, for what you've done. And you know what? He forgives you of all of your past, of everything that you ever did. Jesus forgives you. Forgive them that trespass against me, Lord. In other words, forgive them that do me wrong. Forgive them that hurt me. Forgive them that say bad things about me, that slanders my name. Forgive them, Lord. You know, the Bible goes on to say that He will heap coals of fire on their head if you pray that prayer. Now, don't pray that prayer just so some heaping will go on. That's what I said. I said, well, I just pray that prayer and let God heap the coals on their head. Praise God. That's why I learned it and memorized it. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I pray for my enemy. Heap coals of fire on their head, Lord. But really, in sincerity, forgive them their trespasses. Lead us not into temptation. That's not talking about God leading us into temptation, because God will not tempt you. He will test you. And it's up to us to pass those tests. But deliver us from evil, for He is a great deliverer. No matter how close your feet get to the fan, to the fires of hell, all you have to do is call on the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And He'll pull you back every time. I know that sometimes, especially for young people, the world seems tempting. It seems like it's a lot of fun. You see a lot of people out there partying and going on and acting crazy and drinking beer and liquor and doing drugs. You say, man, I'm missing out. Let me tell you something. If you know Jesus, you're not missing out on anything.
Amen.
Nothing. And I'll get some people in here to give their testimony one day, and they'll tell you just what destruction it brings with it.
Amen.
The Bible says there's fun and there's pleasure in sin for a season. That means, you know what that means? That means after that first cocaine high, you'll always be chasing the same high. That means after that first drunk, you'll always be chasing that first drunk, and you'll never catch it, but it'll catch you. It'll catch you and it'll destroy your life. It'll take your children. It'll take your husband. It'll take your wife. It'll take your family. It'll take everything around you, and you'll be standing alone with the bottle or with the joint or with the drugs, and you'll say, well, everybody else has left me. And in that shape, in that situation, you'll hear a small, still voice saying, I forgive you. And I love you. And your heart melts because you know how low down you are. And everybody else, you've cheated people out of money. You've done your loved ones wrong. Nobody trusts you anymore. But Jesus still looks down from glory and says, I love you. And dusts you off and picks you up and said, I'm going to give you another chance. And he keeps on and on and on. The Bible says, how long should we say I forgive you? Jesus said 7 times 70. In other words, every time they ask.
Yeah.
Every time they ask, forgive me. Amen. You are forgiven. That's what Jesus tells us. We are forgiven. We are to be the happiest people on the face of earth because we are forgiven.
Amen.
Don't live in the past. There's nothing in the past. Live in the now. Today. Today, we're not promised a tomorrow, but Jesus will walk through the day with us. He has forgiven us. We are children of the King. We are priests in a priesthood. We are on our way to glory, and we have been forgiven. Give the Lord a hand clap. We have.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Been forgiven. Now, to the forgetting. Oh, it's easy to forgive. I forgive you, but I'll never forget it. Woo, Lord, that ain't what Jesus said. Mm-hmm. He didn't say, I forgive you and I love you, but I'll never forget what you did. No, he said he throws it into the sea of forgetfulness, never to be brought up before us again.
Amen.
As far as the sea, he throws that sin. When we forgive somebody, we have to forget it.
Yeah.
Forget it. Don't put it in the back of our mind to use against them someday. Which a lot of people's guilty of that. Throwing stuff up, I think it's what it's called.
Yeah.
Well, you did this to me. Well, you're supposed to forgive me for that. I forgave you, but I ain't going to forget.
Uh-huh.
That's not biblical. It may be the way you learned it, but it's not the way I read it. And it don't sit well with me in my heart. The Bible says, forget and forgive.
Yeah.
Just like Jesus did. Remember, unforgiveness will not enter the kingdom of heaven. If we walk through this life saved or unsaved. And somebody told me one time, said, if you can't forgive, you haven't really been saved. Yes, you have. If you went to an altar or right there in your pew, you asked Jesus into your heart, you were saved.
Yeah.
But that don't mean you were sanctified and made perfect.
Right.
That don't mean that all that stuff all of a sudden floated off to heaven and you're perfect. No, you've got a battle to fight. What's that mean is you just put on the armor of God and said, I'm ready to fight, Lord.
Yeah.
Take all this junk out of my life. And taking all that junk out of your life takes time. But the first one we need to work on is forgiving. Forgiving and forgetting. I forgive you. If you don't think you can forget, don't reconcile that relationship. Don't reconcile what you're trying to put together. Because if you always throw that up, that's not going to work. Somebody said, well, I'm going to take them back. They cheated on me 15 times, but I'm going to take them back. You know the first thing I say when I'm counseling? Can you forget it? Every time they're late from coming back in the grocery store, can you forget it? Or is it going to be on your mind? Maybe they're cheating on me again. If you're going to live like that, it's best to live without them. Forget it. Forgive and forget. I know that trust is the hardest thing in the world to build back. But remember, when we fail, Jesus trusts us one more time. He said, I trust you, I forgive you, and I forget it. And we start new with, oh, what a wonderful God.
Amen.
What a wonderful, merciful God.
Amen.
Full of grace. Not flashing a card in front of us every time. Remember what you did. Remember what you did. I remember what I did, Lord. I can't forget it. I was bad. And so were some of you. But thank God for a forgiving Savior. Wayne, He forgave us, brother. And He forgot it. He forgave us, and He forgot it. Would you bow your heads in this place as Miss Caroline comes and sings? Father God, make us, mold us. Make us better Christians, Lord. Teach us how to forgive. Not only to forgive, Lord, but to forget. When people ask us, would you forgive me? I did not mean to say that, or I did not mean to do that. Soften our heart, Lord Jesus. Let us teach like you taught. I forgive you, and I forget it in the name of Jesus. And the reason why, Lord, because we want to be like you. We want to be just like you, Lord Jesus. Teach us how to forgive. Teach us how to forget. Teach us how to love with an agape love, Lord. Not with a lustful love or another love, but with agape love. An unconditional love, Lord, like you love the church. Father God, we'll be careful to give you all the honor and all the praise and all the glory. As they sing, would you come and just talk to Jesus for a moment? Would you come and just talk to Him? This altar's open. Please come.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I found, was blind.
Please give as you have been blessed. Remember what we said about tithes and offerings. They are a time of worship. Amen. So worship the Lord in your tithes and offerings. My strength is gone. My heart is full of sorrow. I can't believe how much I've let you down. I dread the pain that waits for me tomorrow. As the sun reveals my broken dreams, scattered on the ground. Too grace to make it through. All I have is you. Imagine mercy, Lord. I'll serve you until my dying day. Help others find their way. Imagine mercy, please forgive me. Church yard sale. Please come, bring some stuff, and join in with us, and let's raise money for the church. The Saturday after that will be the church yard car wash. So come and be a part of that also. Bring some stuff Saturday to sale. No matter what it is, just bring it. Let's sell it. Those old exercise stuff you've had on the back porch for a while or in the basement, let's sell it. Stepmasters are not even in anymore. Buns of Steel videos, bring them. Let's sell it. Amen. Ain't in anymore. Five Masters ain't in anymore. Let's sell it. Amen. I know you seen it on TV. You fell in love with it, but let's sell it. Amen. Would you bow your heads? Father God, we come to you in the precious name of Jesus. We thank you for your spirit that we felt in this place today. We thank you for every decision that's been made. We thank you for this place of worship. Everyone that stood and sang, thank you for the anointing, Lord. Thank you for the word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Give someone a hug before you go home, and God bless you.